Hair shedding after PRP treatment. Why is this happening? I've seen a lot of positive results in PRP over the internet, and I've undergone 3 sittings of PRP over the last 3 months. But to my bad, I'm having severe hair shedding since 10 days from my first sitting. It's been 2 months and still shedding is continuing. Daily, more than 50 to 100 strands of hair is falling from my hair, with white bulb attached to tip. I lost almost all my hair in crown area. Also, hair on sides is also becoming thin and unable to grow. Can anyone tell me why this is happening?
Thank you for your question. You've submitted several photos, and you describe that you have been, based on positive information about PRP, that you went and had 3 separate sessions of PRP over the course of 3 months for your hair loss. And yet you state that you have been continuously shedding hair essentially since the first month, and that it's getting even worse into the third month, where you're describing 50 to 100 hairs, you see the white part of the hair follicle, and you want to get some explanation as to what's going on. Well, I think I can give you some perspective. I am a board-certified cosmetic surgeon. I've been performing hair transplant for over 20 years. I'm also the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers, which is based on a technology and method we've developed called hair regeneration using acellular matrix or extracellular matrix combined with platelet-rich plasma. So I think I can give you what is first most likely, the most likely reason that I can come up with based on the photos you submitted. And that is that if you have a genetic pattern of hair loss that is aggressive, that is manifested by this type of rapid shedding of hairs, then it's important to understand that PRP alone won't stop it. This is something that where PRP, or platelet-rich plasma, derived from your own blood, has been shown to help grow hair that may be dormant, or I should say in the telogen phase, and may stimulate growth. But that's in distinction from stopping pattern hair loss. We have been very active in using PRP. We use PRP on the face and the skin, we use it in scars, and we use it as a part of our treatment called hair regeneration. The distinction is straightforward. When we treat someone with hair regeneration treatment, we don't have them come in every month. We do the injection and then we observe them for 18 months. And what we have found is that we're able to, for 99% of men, stop hair loss, thinning hair, and in some patients even improve upon the first results by doing another injection. For female pattern hair loss, we have more than 80% response with the same thing, where we stop the hair loss, we stop the progression, we thicken the hair. Now, shedding can be a part of the hair regrowth cycle. When you think about it, if you have a thin hair, that thin hair has to shed before thicker hair comes in. But that applies to our treatment. And we have learned over a long, extensive amount of time and a lot of patients. We have patients who come to us from around the world. It's one of the reasons why we were motivated to start a company to help bring this technology closer to people. And we have a lot of data. So I would say that's my opinion, and I don't in any way want to disrespect any doctor who is doing this, because I know they're doing their best with what they know and what they have. But PRP alone will not stop pattern hair loss. With that being said, it is possible that your hair is really just manifesting the pattern hair loss. It is not unusual for a younger person as young as 18 to lose hair very quickly and can be bald by the time they're 22. There are different patterns. Some people start losing hair later and they lose it slowly. Other people, and a lot of this is derived from looking at your family history. Another thing to think about is whether or not getting the treatment frequently done can be causing something called shock. And shock is from scalp trauma or inflammation from the injection. We know this from, especially from hair transplant. You can do the surgery, place the grafts, and in the first few months, you can get what's called shock loss. The thinning, the hairs that were grafted can shed, and the adjacent hairs that were not grafted can also shed. So you can look like you have less hair than you had from the beginning. Now that's one thought. Again, this is something that you should discuss with your doctor. But I can't emphasize enough to understand, for you to understand that it doesn't stop pattern hair loss. It can help someone with slow progression to maybe thicken up their hair. But usually people find, at least the people who've come to us, I should say, have found it gets really tiresome to get scalp injections every month. And eventually, a lot of people stop, and then they learn more about alternatives like hair regeneration. So again, meet with your doctor, learn more about hair regeneration and similar treatments, and then hopefully you'll be able to intervene early enough to help you save your hair. So with that, I hope that was helpful, and thank you for your question.